Everyone, welcome to another Figma animation tutorial. It's a festive time all over the world. In this video, let's recreate this beautiful confetti animation to match festive mood. Don't forget to check out Aaron's dribble page for more such animations. Oh, by the way, this is my last video in 2020. I want to take a moment to thank all of you and wish you a very healthy and prosperous new year. Alright, let's jump right into our tutorial. You can download the practice file from the link in the description and comment section. We'll be using the Loti Files plugin in the tutorial. You can find that in the community tab. Make sure it's installed. Once it's installed, go back to our file. This animation has three states. First, default state. Second is prey state, where confetti blaster shrinks a little. And the third is the final confetti animation state. Let's start with first state. This confetti blaster is created using ellipse tool, paint tool and boolean operations. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see a detailed tutorial on advanced vector design. Next, we need confetti. To get it, open lotifiles.com. Simply search for confetti in search box. Look for the ideal animation. I like this one here. You can just download and use animated GIF of your choice right away. If you preview this frame, you will notice that there is a small problem. GIF files run in a loop and we don't want that in the first state. So let's open our Loti Files plugin. Download the JSON file of the same and open that in the plugin. Now we can do bunch of actions here, like changing the color of the background, converting JSON to GIF, or just static SVG image. Select the frame just before it blasts open. This looks good. Click on Insert as SVG. Close the plugin and you will see that it is added on the frame. I don't want outer frame, so just ungroup that. I will rotate it roughly by 45 degrees. Place it correctly inside the layers. Make it look like it is inside a blaster. First state looks good. Copy paste this blaster and confetti to second state. In this state, we want to shrink a blaster little. So select everything together. Use scale feature to scale everything down. Keyboard shortcut is letter K. I'll move the confetti inside the cone to make it realistic. Modify the background rectangle to make it look like a priest. You can do that by changing drop shadow to inner shadow and changing the fill color. Done. Now let's move to the third state. You can add animated GIF file here. Change blending mode to darken. Place it little away from the blaster as if it is bursting out. It's time to animate this. Let's go to prototype tab and connect first and second state, which is press state. Here, choose trigger as while pressing, animation as smart animate, easing to is in and out back for nice bounce effect, duration to 150 milliseconds for quick transition. Connect the second and third frame together. This time, we want to trigger an animation as soon as we leave the mouse click. So use trigger as touch up or mouse up, animation as smart animate and duration to 300 milliseconds. Preview this animation. Everything looks good except the final state. animated confettis are not coming from the blaster. Let's go back and fix that. Smart Animate needs the same layer on the both frames. Duplicate this animated GIF on the second state. Reduce its size and place it inside the blaster. We don't want it to be visible on the second state, hence change the opacity to 0. Connect the third frame back to first, as we don't want animated GIF to play in the loop. Done. Reload the animation again. This looks wonderful. Show off your design skills by recording the screen and sharing this animation on LinkedIn, Instagram, and Dribbble. Tag me in your post so that I can provide my suggestions if required. Hit like if this video was helpful. Subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay notified with the upcoming Figma tutorials. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you in the next one.